New regulations are here to remind parents not to be in a rush to move their child from one car seat up to the next.
Car seat safety is one of the quickest and easiest ways to keep our children safe. When we're using the proper car seat and installing the children properly in the car seat, then the children are less likely to be injured in a car crash. Parents may be unaware that they are moving their child a little too early from one car seat to the next, when in fact, if they kept them in their current car seat, the child would be safer. The federal government has introduced updated car seat safety regulations. These regulations affect the manufacturers of car seats only. Parents do not need to replace their current car seats. So one of the new regulations that have been implemented is that they have changed the definition of what an infant's weight is. An infant's weight has gone from 9 kilograms now to 10 kilograms, which translated into pounds is from 20 pounds to 22 pounds. It's best to keep infants in rear-facing position because infants have weak neck and back muscles. So in the event of a crash, the rear-facing position will better absorb the shock of that crash. Sometimes parents are concerned that their baby's legs are bent or their feet are touching the back of the seat, but that's okay for that to happen. As long as your baby falls within the car seat's weight and height limits, then they are still safest in a rear-facing position. Another change that was made in the regulations was the maximum allowable weight for a child seat. It has changed from 22 kilograms to 30 kilograms, or in pounds, that's 48 pounds to 66 pounds. The forward-facing car seat can accommodate a much larger child. The important thing is to follow your manufacturer's instructions on what the height and weight limitations are for your car seat. Don't be in a hurry to move your child up to a booster seat because this is a much safer option. A booster seat is designed to help a child fit properly in a seat belt because seat belts are designed for adults and older children. What a booster seat does is raise the child up so that the lap portion of the seat belt fits nicely firmly against the hips, and the shoulder portion of the seat belt fits nicely along the shoulder and not rubbing up against the child's neck. So it's very important for that seatbelt to fit properly on the child because in the event of a crash or a sudden stop, if it's not fitting properly on the hips and it's up too high, you may have internal damage to organs. And if it's not properly fitted on the shoulder, let's say it's up against the neck, you could have serious back neck injuries. A child is ready to move into a seatbelt only when they are at least 4 foot 9 inches, they are 80 pounds or they are 8 years old. But there's still a few other ways to check that your child is ready to use a seatbelt alone. Have your child sit nice and tall with their back up against the back of the car seat. Ensure that their knees are hanging over that lower seat, and as well, ensure that their feet are touching the floor. Often parents get really excited to see their child graduate from one car seat to the next. But what we got to keep in mind is we want to keep them as safe as possible. So that may mean keeping them in that particular car seat for as long as possible.